Another good technique to learn is how to duplicate a mask. This is really helpful when you want to reuse a mask because it prevents you from having to create that same mask over and over again. Duplicating a mask is quite simple. You press and hold the Option or Alt key, and then you drag the mask to where you want it to go. So for this example, I have a curves layer at the bottom, and I'd like to reuse the same mask for another layer at the top. So I press and hold the Option or Alt key and click and drag it. And you'll also see your cursor change to kind of this double cursor. And then when you release, you'll usually get a pop-up that asks you if you want to replace it. So you'll choose yes. You can also check the box if you just don't want to see that again. And then once you release, you'll have that new mask duplicated on whichever layer you dragged it to. Let's jump into Photoshop and I'll show you how this works firsthand. For this image, I've already done some luminosity masking. I'll show you a before and after preview just by pressing and hold the Option or Alt key, and then I click that eyeball at the bottom so you can see the before and after. What I'd like to do is add some more contrast to kind of that center area with the mountains and the grass, but I don't really want it to affect the water or the sky. The layer that I've used to edit the shadows already has a pretty good mask that will work. If I press and hold the Option or Alt key and click the mask, you can see that the mountains are masked in white. And so that means that whatever is added to that layer is affecting the mountains. So I'd like to create a layer and use that exact same mask. I'll go ahead and start out by clicking that top layer, and I'm going to add a black and white adjustment layer. I'm not actually going to convert it to black and white, but instead I'm going to change the blending mode of this layer down to soft light. And if I toggle it off and on, you can see it's adding some nice contrast, but it's applying it to everything. So I'm going to take that mask from the shadows and duplicate it so it's in the black and white layer. So I'll go ahead and start out by pressing and holding the Option or Alt key. I'm going to click and drag that mask from the shadows and then release it over the black and white layer. Now, I didn't have that pop-up come up because I've probably already cleared it in the past. But if you do this on your own and you see a pop-up appear, go ahead and click yes, and then you'll get exactly what I got right there. So now if I toggle that top layer off and on, you can see it's only affecting the areas that are masked. Now I could go in and edit this mask if I wanted to because it's still independent of the other masks, but that saved me a lot of time from having to redo the mask entirely.